Hello, everybody. Welcome back to House of Games. I'm Richard Osman. Four famous faces are battling it out all week over a series of ridiculous quiz rounds. Someone on Friday is winning a trophy. It's going to be one of these four people. Max George. Olly Smith. Scarlette Douglas. And Susie McCabe. Welcome back, everyone. Olly, a win for you yesterday.
Yes.
It was very, very close, and then you absolutely just floored it on Answer Smash. Good round for you.
Well, yeah, I went from not knowing where I was born to kind of finally kind of finding my rhythm.
Yes. To be fair, you knew where you were born.
Yes.
You knew nothing about the place.
Correct, correct. Exactly, yes, that's exactly what
Which is slightly different. Susie, didn't do badly yesterday, but second place. What can we do today about getting a win?
I just need to be better. I need to take out Olly. This is what I need to do. I need to take him out.
See, it's so interesting because there are two completely different things there. The first one of which I applauded, I need to be better, which is great for life. Sometimes you just need to, don't you? And then it was, I need to take out Olly.
Yeah.
And I thought, I didn't. And it was immediate.
Yes.
Yeah. It was immediate. Yes. But listen, a little bit of both, maybe. A little bit of both. Scarlett, good show for you yesterday as well. Olly took home some sliders.
Yes.
Today's prizes. Shall we take a little
Let's
look?
Let's have a look.
You could win the hot water bottle cover, you could win the onesie, the decanter, the playing cards, or the cycle helmet. What do you think?
I'm going for the onesie.
You're going onesie?
I absolutely love a onesie, yeah.
I can see you presenting in a onesie.
And I will do that, just
That would
for
work.
You.
Oh, thank you very much. I appreciate that. Max, what do you think you would go for from there?
Probably the hot water bottle.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah, it's cold, isn't it, at the minute?
Do you know I forget you're from Manchester?
Yeah, so hot water bottle year round.
Fourth place yesterday. What are we gonna do about that?
I've got to be better. I've said that for a long time.
And every day and every way,
every
I must
day.
Try and improve.
And I've got to take all three of these out.
Yeah, you've got to take all three of them out. That's
so,
even more annoying.
Yeah, it's a big ask.
And it just, Olly, what would you go for if you were to win?
Without question, the decanter.
I mean, you can't be a wine expert and a drinks expert and not go for the decanter.
Everything's going to taste 10% better from that decanter. Yeah. It's a fact.
30% better.
50.
85.
100.
Okay, 100% better. That's what we're saying. Susie, what would you go for?
I would want the decanter.
Yeah.
But I've been told it has to be the cycle helmet.
Who is telling you that?
It's my betrothed.
Susie, are you absolutely committed to this relationship?
I'm having second thoughts, although I did look at the onesie, but I thought, is that onesie to your size?
It's to anyone's size.
Right.
We can we can have them cut by our master tailors.
Right, OK.
But you're going cycle helmet. What's the name of your fiancé?
Nicola.
Nicola. Fingers crossed, Nicola. Let's take a look at the leaderboard from yesterday. Ollie's at the top, as we can see, but still 4 days to go. So, all to play for. Let's play round one today, and it is... the answers in the question. Max, I'm going to start with you. I'm going to give you a category, which is... herbs. OK, I'm going to ask you a question about herbs.
Yeah.
Somewhere in that question, there will be some capital letters, and the answer will also happen to be an anagram of those letters. OK?
Right.
OK, which herb is this, please, Max? This leafy herb has been around for ages. Ancient peoples used it as a medicine.
Sage.
I mean, is it? Could it be sage? It absolutely is, Max. Well done. Olly, let's have one for you. Which herb is this, please? This aromatic herb adds colour and flavour as a garnish for curry and or rice.
Is it coriander?
Must be, isn't it? It is, and or rice is coriander. Scarlett, I have a herb for you.
Okay.
A mixed herb. Add this herb to a mushroom tagliatelle and oh my, the result is a taste sensation.
Time.
Time. These feel easier than this round normally is, but that's good. Time. It's nice to have a nice gentle introduction on Tuesday, isn't it?
Exactly.
Time. Susie, now this will be like some herb from like, yeah. What herb is this, please, Susie? I'm not fond of eating fish with this leafy herb, though I'm not so arrogant as to never try it again.
Is it tarragon?
Do you know what? I honestly think the answer there was easier than reading the question. Three negatives in one question.
Yeah, that's
How about right. that? Tarragon. Absolutely is tarragon. Well done, Susie. Max, we go back to you. Not herbs this time. Horror films. Which horror film is this, please, Max? If Jack Torrance thinks staying at the Overlook Hotel will lead to a quiet night in, he's sorely mistaken.
Is it The Shining?
Is it The Shining? That is exactly what it is, The Shining. Jack Nicholson as Jack Torrance in The Shining. Olly, a horror film for you. To satisfy your dark lusts or macabre urges, you could watch Gary Oldman in this 90s classic.
Ooh.
God, well done to our question writers.
Yeah, Gary Oldman, 90s classic, OK. I'm thinking Dracula, but I can't quite make head or tail of it.
No, should time you out?
Yeah, time me out.
Anyone else want to buzz in? Susie's going for it.
Bram Stoker's Dracula.
Bram Stoker's Dracula. Well done, Susie, for working that out. Bram Stoker's Dracula. Scarlette, I have a horror film for you. Just when the mother of a possessed child fears that things could turn really toxic, there's an offer of help from a priest.
Oh, The Exorcist.
The Exorcist? It is The Exorcist. Well done. And Susie, to finish the round off, question for you. In this film, children are attacked in their dreams, so if you prefer something more mainstream, other gentle movies are available. Have you got this one at home? Should time you out, Susie?
Yeah, time me out.
Anybody? Olly.
Is it Nightmare on Elm Street?
Yes.
Absolutely. Well done, Olly. It's the end of the round. End of that round. Susie stole Ollie's question. Ollie stole Susie's, which means everybody is on 2 points.
Ooh.
How about that? 2-2-2-2. Nice way to start the show. And let's get on and play our pairs game. It is You Complete Me. Player in last place chooses. Ollie, you're last currently, although also first.
Yes.
But would you like to choose a partner?
Yeah, I'd be delighted. I'll stick with Max because we're
sitting next to
each other.
No one's moving. So
yeah.
Those two children's programs, Max and Olly, and Scarlett and Susie are back again.
Oh yeah.
Now on You Complete Me, what I'm going to do is read you out a series of questions. Fingers on the buzzers, everyone. Every answer will have two words in it. If you buzz in, I just want you to give me the first word of the answer. Your partner must then give me the second word for you to score a point. Okay? Here is your first question. Just give me the first word of this answer, please. Which 1993 film stars Jason James Richter as a boy who befriends an orca? Yes, that is Max.
Free.
Free is correct. Olly for the point.
Willy.
Sorry?
Willy.
Free Willy. Absolutely right. Well done. Free Willy. Point to Max and Olly. Next question. Which band had a UK top 10 hit in 1971 with Won't Get Fooled Again? Nobody. It's got a very familiar first word for a band. Yes, Scarlett.
There.
There is correct, Scarlett. Well played. You've done a lot of the hard work here. Susie.
Osmonds?
The Osmonds? It's a good guess. It's not, I'm afraid. Gents, anyone? Olly?
Who?
Who?
Yeah.
Answer, well done.
Quick little guess.
Got yourself a point there, Max.
I know, Lion Arthur.
Next one. What's the first word of this answer? The last chapter of which novel by Charlotte Bronte begins with the line, "Reader, I married him." Olly.
Jane.
Jane is correct. Max for a point.
I have no idea. Sorry, mate. Fonda.
I love it.
Let's see. Is it Jane Fonda? Absolutely gutted.
Gutted.
Other team, sorry, anyone buzzing? Yes, Scarlett.
Air.
Jane Eyre. It was Jane Eyre. Absolutely. Well played, Scarlett. The next question. What is the title, please, first word only, of this song?
Dragonfly out in the sun, you know what I mean, don't you know? Butterfly.
Yes, that is Max.
Feeling.
Feeling is correct, Olly.
Good.
Feeling good? Absolutely, gentlemen, well played.
Well played.
Redeemed it.
Well worked out, Max, by Nina Simone. First word of this, please. Richard Ayoade and Joe Lycett have both hosted which Channel 4 tourism series? Yes, Olly.
Travel?
travel is correct. Max?
I'll pass it over.
Before you say sorry, agent. Anyone want to buzz in on the other team? Yes, Scarlett.
Man.
Travel man.
I've never thought travel man.
Final question in this round. What is the title of this song? I must confess, because I've had about enough. Oh, Max buzzed and his finger slid off. Susie got in there.
All
is correct.
I thought it was well in then.
Yeah, I thought you were.
Rise.
Right. All Rise by Blue. The band that wished they were the ones, right?
It's a bit dodgy, that, dodgy, you know. Buzzer. It's a dodgy one. It was hitting that.
I saw you do it. You know what? It was bad technique, if you don't mind me saying so.
Well, yeah, I've been told that.
By Blue, very, very well played. It's the end of the round. Well played, everyone. There's some great answering.
We missed out on that one
as well. Some very, very bad buzzer technique from certain members of the Wanted. But apart from that, it was terrific. Let's take a look at the leaderboard. Two rounds down. We were 2 points all at the start of it. Take a look at that.
Oh.
Wow, that's nice to see. 5 points each, that's good stuff. Three rounds to go. Can we get amongst them with our third round? Today it is Z2A. Fingers on buzzers, please. I'm going to show you three clues at a time. OK, something connects those clues. Buzz in when you know what connects them. However, I'm going to reveal those clues one letter at a time, from Z all the way up to A. So buzz in when you've worked out what the clues are and what connects them. What connects these three, please? Yes, Susie.
Are they forms of monkeys?
Are they primates? Forms of monkeys?
Primates.
They absolutely are. I think the actual answer was apes, but forms of monkeys.
I was very nervous, Richard.
I like forms of monkeys. Apes or primates or forms of monkeys, if you said that at home. Well done. Chimpanzee, orangutan, and gorilla. What connects these three, please? So frustrating at the beginning. Yes, that is Olly.
They are all in Scotland. Towns and cities in Scotland, isn't it?
Yeah, Scottish cities, absolutely. One of them we are literally in.
Yeah.
Glasgow, Inverness and Stirling. All lovely places. Next three. What connects these, please? Olly.
Are they Beatles songs?
They are not, I'm afraid. I mean, you're very close. They are not Beatles songs. Susie.
Beatles albums.
Beatles albums. Abbey Road, not the song.
Yeah, of course.
Yellow Submarine, Let It Be, Abbey Road. Every single round so far, but I can just say that Max, the second someone buzzes in, goes, ugh, because he's buzzed in like a split second later. What connects these three, please? Oh, there's a Z. I always think the Z's useful. Yes, that is Scarlett.
Film directors.
Yeah. They're film directors? They are. Baz Luhrmann, Catherine Bigelow, Steven Spielberg. Next three. Connects these. Yes, Susie.
Are they Central American countries?
That's exactly what we were looking for. Belize, Guatemala, Costa Rica. Well played, Susie. Lovely answer. Next three. Yes, Susie.
Are they detective shows?
Are they detectives? What detective shows? They absolutely are. Wexford, Bergerac, and Poirot. Final question. What connects these? Yes, Scarlett.
Are they all fruits?
Are they all fruits? They are not. Yes, Olly.
Are they a type of dance?
Are they a type of dance? Is incorrect. Max.
Drake songs.
Are they Drake songs? They are Drake singles. Well played, Max. Lovely end to the round. Great round for Susie, that. Let's take a look at our leaderboard. I know. You know it's awful when you're doing well, isn't it?
The pressure.
I know, but I feel that I've let myself down with my primate's answer.
Oh, that was my favourite bit. My favourite bit. Nicola's at home thinking, oh, let's take a look at the leaderboard.
Bring home the cycle helmet. That's
Nicola, take a look at this leaderboard. Two rounds to go. Susie's got a 3-point lead. Close, 6 points to the rest of you, so only 3 points in it. 2 rounds to go as well. Plenty of time to catch up. Round four is... I'm terrible at dating. You'll take your tablets out, please. I'm going to give you a series of events from world history. You have to write down the year in which you think they happened. And that's such a brilliant expression. That's exactly how I feel. Max just went...
Yeah, I'm with you, Max.
Whoever is nearest will score themselves a point. Play along at home, see if you can get closer than us in the studio. The first thing we'd like a date for is this. The BBC broadcast the first TV sitcom. When was that? We need to be as closer than anyone else on this one. So, everyone happy? Max, what's your thinking here?
I was sort of thinking broadcast, like I was thinking the 66 World Cup. So I was thinking maybe a little bit before that, so I've gone 1958.
1958? Yeah. Sounds reasonable to me. Olly, what are you thinking?
Well, extraordinarily, I've chosen exactly the same date as Max.
1958?
Yeah, my thinking being that I can't remember sitcoms pre-war, not to say they weren't, but I can't remember any. And I know they were around in the 60s and 70s, so I think the 50s feels about right. You've got the coronation, you've got Everest, you've got a few things happening. Sitcoms.
Then some sitcoms. Scarlett, what have you
said? I also
here?
Had 1958, but then changed to 1962. I don't know why I decided to add a few years on.
Mad
What's
that?
Going on with 1962?
I know.
62 and then.
What did you put in our team?
Max went 62 and went down to 58.
No what way.
Whoa.
That's weird.
Whoa, this is crazy. Susie, don't spoil it.
I thought the coronation was the biggest TV event that happened in this country post-war, up to the World Cup. So I thought, with everyone buying televisions, that's when the BBC changed their game, and I went 1953.
Interesting. Interesting. So 53. So 53, 58, 58, 62. What do you think at home on this one? I tell you, it was a sitcom called Pinwright's Progress, about a shopkeeper. But in what year was it first broadcast? Who scored the point? 1946. Wow. Susie, you get yourself a point.
Wow.
Wow. That's madness, isn't it? 1946. Someone just told me in my ear it was broadcast live.
Wow.
A live sitcom in 1946. Wow. I mean, they've been through the war. They're probably.
They're ready.
What's the worst that can happen? You fluff a line.
Yeah, exactly.
Let's do another one, shall we? The Mary Rose warship sinks in battle in the English Channel. When was that? I'm old enough to remember when they raised it from the seabed.
I remember that, yeah.
It's all over the news, wasn't it?
Yeah, I was so excited, and then it was like a plank.
Yeah, exactly.
Is that
it's like a really old, rotted ship. It's lovely now that they've done it up.
Amazing.
Yeah. OK, everyone in. Olly, what have you gone for?
Well, I went for 1510.
I am so off.
Scarlett went like this, and Max went, oh.
I think it was Henry VIII's flagship, but I'm not sure. So I don't know if he was on the throne then. I think it's around then. Okay. My GCSE and A-level history is, like, failing me massively.
1510, roughly, Olly is saying. Yeah. Scarlett, your hand went to your mouth. What have you said?
I'm going to pretend that this 9 should really be a 5.
Uh-oh. 1947.
Absolutely zero... clue.
Susie, where are you? Second World War, or are you more near Olly?
I'm more near Olly. I've went 1654.
Max?
I've just split the difference and I went 1820.
1820, nice. Why not? So we're in four entirely different centuries. I have to say, not for the first time in this round. What century are you in at home, if you know what I mean? Let's take a look. When did the Mary Rose warship sink and who scored a point? 1545. Oh, wow. Olly, you get a point. Well done. Get the point. Absolutely. It was Henry VIII's flagship. Final question in this round. The glass pyramid entrance of the Louvre Museum is opened to the public. When did that happen? Anyone been to the Louvre?
Yeah.
You have to, don't you, if you go to Paris? One of those things. They force you.
I might be way off here.
OK, what do you think about this one? Scarlett, I don't really know where to start with this one. What have you gone for?
I don't, but I'm just thinking the glass pyramid entrance might have been built a lot later than the actual museum itself. I mean, and obviously been open to the public. So, I mean, I'm terrible, so I'm just going to be more terrible, continue in 1969.
Well, that's what I'm wondering, was it a modern thing or was it early than you think?
Yeah,
I don't think that's a crazy answer at all. 1969 says Scarlett. Susie, what's your thinking?
I'm with Scarlett, and I think the way that you would have to structure the glass, it would have to be more towards this side. So I have went 1972.
1972. You're thinking advances in the glazing industry.
Mm. Yeah.
Is where you're going from.
Yeah, and just the construction industry and how you would build that.
Yeah, they probably started in 1680 by the time they were finished. Max, you're in a similar place?
Well, different century.
But... so, a not similar place is how we'd say it.
Yeah, I said 1890. I was thinking more when it was actually the whole place the was opened, not the
glass. But you never know. Sometimes.
Well, I don't know.
Exactly. Like the Crystal Palace, that was all glass.
Yeah.
Wasn't it? And that was way back when. Olly, what are you saying?
My feeling is that it was modern times. I have a vague memory, I think, maybe of it actually happening in my lifetime.
Oh, OK.
So I've gone for 1995.
1995. Yeah. So we do have a difference of opinion here. What do you think at home on this one? Would not have a clue. Who scored the last point of the round? 1989, Olly. Well done.
Well done, Olly.
Well done. The museum itself opened nearly 200 years before, but the Glass Pyramid, 1989. Tablets away, please, everyone.
It's just 100 years off.
Just 100, listen.
Round number.
I mean, we've had people like 2,000 years off in that round, so 100 years is like almost dead on.
OK.
Let's take a look at the leaderboard. One round to go. Is Susie's partner, Nicola, going to win a cycle helmet is the question we're all asking. Max and Scarlett, 6 each. Olly with 8. Susie with 10. It's pretty close. And Olly was very good at answers yesterday, wasn't he? All four of you were in it to win it. Our final round, of course, is... Answer Smash. Your first category is... mammals. Fingers on buzzers. Point for a correct answer, point off for an incorrect answer. Here's your first one. What two words come before hooray in an expression showing appreciation for someone? That is Scarlett.
Hippopotamus.
Is Scarlett, well done. Hip and hippopotamus. That's weirdly complicated.
Yeah.
Isn't it? Next clue, next picture. Which athletic contest in which two teams pull opposite ends of a rope is also the title of a 1982 album by Paul McCartney? Scarlett.
Tug of Warthog.
Tug of Warthog? Well played, Scarlett.
Well done.
Next clue, next picture. What two words precede wrote in the title of the TV series starring Angela Lansbury as the amateur sleuth Jessica Fletcher? That is Susie.
Murder sheep.
Murder she and sheep. Murder sheep. Your next category is British sports stars. A well-known expression about taking something away from one person in order to give it to another is robbing Peter to do what? Yes, Scarlett.
Robbing Peter to pay... Pauline.
Sorry, Scarlett, you lose a point. Anybody? Olly.
Pay Paula Radcliffe.
Absolutely, Olly. Pay Paula Radcliffe is what we were looking for. Pay Paul and Paula Radcliffe. Next clue, next picture. What is the title of the 1994 Louis de Bernier novel set on the Greek island of Cephalonia? Yes, Olly.
Captain Corelli's mandolin for Christie.
It's absolutely right.
Well done.
Absolutely right. Some of them are harder than others, aren't they?
Blimey.
Captain Corelli's mandolin for Christie. There's a lot going on there. Next clue, next picture. Which 1996 single that has a music video set in a car was the fourth UK Top 40 hit for Alanis Morissette? So, Tilly? Oh, Susie.
Nicola Ironic.
It's incorrect, I'm afraid. You lose a point. So, Tilly, we were looking for Ironicola Adams. Just the other way round. Ironic and Nicola Adams. Ironicola Adams. There's another Nicola thinking that's ironic. Next category. No more categories. What has Susie done at the last second there? Let's find out, has she done it? Olly, you won on Monday. Our winner on Tuesday is... going down to a tie-break between Olly and Susie. That point you lost at the last minute there, Susie.
I can't believe it.
Susie. We will do one more question of Answer Smash, one more British sports star, Olly and Susie. If you buzz in and give me a correct answer, you are our winner. If you buzz in and give me an incorrect answer, your opponent is our winner. OK? Here we go. They're calling it the Battle of the Cycle Helmet. Here is your question. Which song was a UK Top 40 hit for Wilson Pickett in December 1966 and featured in the film The Commitments? Yes, that is Susie.
Mustang Sally Gunnell.
Is it Mustang Sally Gunnell for a cycle helmet? It is! Well played, Susie. Very nicely done. You held your nerve. Yeah. You lost your nerve.
Yes.
And then you regained your nerve. Yep. Which is even more impressive than just holding your nerve. Susie, you have won a prize. Which of these would you like?
It has to be the cycle helmet.
It has to be the cycle helmet. Very well done, Susie. Well done, Nicola, as well. Let's take a look at our weekly leaderboard, shall we? 2 days done. Max with 2, Scarlett with 4. We have joint leaders, Olly and Susie, 7 points each. Well done, one and all. Should we do it again tomorrow?
Absolutely.
See if we can prizes for other people. Yes. That'd be nice. Thank you all for playing. I'll see you tomorrow. We'll see you as well tomorrow on the House of Games.
It's a great wedding gift. She might just keep her room. No,
you know what? I don't know if it is a good wedding gift.
It's to keep her safe.
You wear it down the aisle.
Yeah.
Keep her safe.
If she cycles down the aisle, it's a great wedding gift.
I tell you what. Stranger things have happened at a Glasgow wedding, to be fair.